Hey guys, Dom from the Geek Door here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to The Owl House Season 3, Episode 3, titled Watching and Dreaming. This is the finale of the series, and the synopsis is: the fate of everything on the Boiling Isles now rests on the shoulders of a human, a cursed witch, and a tiny but determined little king. Now, I have not seen anything from this show. I did not watch the snake trailers or anything. So I am going into this completely blind. But it is upsetting that this has to be the finale because, well, even with 3 feature-length episodes, it's still not as long as a season would have normally been. But there's no way to change it now. I'm just glad we were able to mostly finish what their plan was, even if it did have to be amended and shortened into what this is. Because realistically, each of these specials is probably a third of what the final season would have been. But yeah. Now, I am recording this later than I would have liked because it has only just gone up on the site that I can watch it on. So unfortunately, that means this reaction is going to be out a couple days later than everyone else's, but oh, at least I still get to watch it relatively quickly. Let's get this started in 3, 2, 1. Go. Sorry about that. It decided to not show up on my screen. 3, 2, 1, start. Of course, the subtitles are weird. Let's do a quick fix. It can send her into this in-between place. Who was that? Looked like a decayed titan, but I don't think Stringbean knows that answer any more than you do. Why is she in the Emperor's room? Well, the conformatorium can no longer hold her. So it seems in a sense they are all in the same dream, or is she in the actual... No, Now they all. Memory play. Yes, Gus. Yep. At least they're not petrified anymore. Battle, not duel. That's fair. You scream? A cosmic playground. I must say, traumatized the little guy. right. Bellis never actually knew that. That looked like a little bit of fear. Didn't he already play with King in person? And thus the day was saved. Of course the cosmic immortal kid doesn't know what death means. Bellis, you're leaking. Well, I mean, they did show that, really, Pac-Man? They did show that the power of love can awaken them, like with Hootie. Marbles. Have you never played this game with people who don't want to play? Jenga? You seem to be losing at all your favorite games. Can we tell you that Belos is still alive? Because. Yeah. You really are going to try and possess the Titan, aren't you? What was that? All you need is to pluck a single core. Oh. No. He's like a cancer. I can't believe I didn't put that together before now, but. Stick together. She found her first natural cliff. You know, I really wasn't expecting this to be the direction it went. Like, we knew that the Collector would have a showdown against Belos, but of course, you've got a beam attack now. Kindness and forgiveness. No. Jump. Why is it not showing string bean? Oh, good. String bean's okay. Ah, she's gone the en route of cosmic dispersal. Can't fix death, buddy. Seeing King and Ida go feral. is not something I expected, but it makes sense with what just happened. Any hoodie? Hoodie, Batgirl coming, glyph pants. He really has a dad fit going on. He killed his own family, so. Like a Dracula. The collector might not be able to bring people back from the dead, but I saw Morton in the back. least Titan magic still works. Oh, you did get hit. Ooh, cool. Now that's a cool design. Eat this. It's a Titan loose. For as bleak as this is meant to be, this is also really, really cool and awesome. Just gonna zip around like Hunter does a little. Blimeline. You could see the other corpses. At least they're still alive. I've got scars from Belos. No, but we can. I knew we'd get one. Hell, the geography of the Bowling Isles may have changed a little. To anyone whose home was at that hand, it's now in the stratosphere. You know, Mark's gonna be real happy with this outcome because this is everything that he's been drawing. There's always been the collector being adopted into the heroes group. Also, Bill's probably gonna be happy with the whole fact that Hootie was seemingly connected to the Titan. You're not human anymore. disappeared in a glyph. She did say he'd love it. So we just gotta gloss over the fact that yet another child has died in one of these shows and been brought back from by a cosmic deity. Oh, not quite cosmic in this case, but Mr. and Mrs. Mr. Park, Mr. Porter. Darius and Ever Wolfing. It was either them or it was going to be Ida. Oh, why must you buffer? Hang on. Okay, it's not quite at the same point, but it's a couple seconds early. Well, that site stopped working, so let's try this one. Unfortunately, it means no subtitles for the rest of it. Oh, poor Edric. You think Bump's gonna keep that statue of him? So the potion guy was as bad as... Was that Bria? Not Bria, No, I was thinking the, Beast Hunter, not... But no. And we still haven't seen Matt and his brother interact. Everyone got to go back to their families, and we didn't see them. Well, Matt and Steve. had a feeling that was going to be the case, but you still got string bean. They did integrate both worlds, by the looks of it. I like the little half Titan, half Earth design on V's shirt. I thought the collector was actually there. No, that's probably just an automated message. Got a little blue jay now. He's got the action. I thought that was Darius that had the side cut. I was so confused. Hey, Lilith has a harpy. We were wondering if we were gonna get that. Oh, why must you buffer as well? I will get this finished one way or another. Some of the kids became students. Bumps retired, by the looks of it. Unbranding people. I saw that blush, Darius. They turned the police station into a hospital. Seems everyone got their happy ending. Was that the guy from the Golden Stone Ruins? Some basilisks? And Ida became the headmaster. I just realized that. She's got a little flapjack tattoo. King Senyera. They all do. Why is it always him? It's a new one. I'm gonna have to go. I was just so enamored by all the good vibes that there are a couple of designs that I want to go back and look at, but was not expecting such a positive ending. You've got good old Salty in the background there. Bat Queen and her three kids, each with a different aesthetic. All the bats, Matt, Farmer Bump, Scarra, Viney, Puddles, Bosher. Our main group, Matholomew, with his actual mustache, the little, whatever that creepy thing that Ida tried to get loose to capture for a bounty. That said, that's rough, buddy, before getting knocked off the statue. Barkus, Gerbo, even Tibbles is there. Why is Tibbles there? Edric looking like a younger Alador, the entire Clawthorn family. Yeah, that was really wholesome ending. I know there's been this thing going around where apparently Dana said that she's not a fan of entirely happy endings. But that's what we got, seeing everyone in their aged up version, seeing what they're doing with their life now that they're in college age. Got to see Lucius King Senyera, which That was nice. There was a question posted at AMA as to whether we'd get to see a quinceañera, but because of the whole rebuilding the aisles, wasn't really feasible. It makes sense. But some of these characters took paths that I was not expecting. Like, I'm assuming Gus is in human studies teacher. Edric seemed to be conjuring his little bat from the knee using beastkeeping. What was that thing called? I don't remember. Yes, that was the Goldstone guy teaching the glass graveyard. Demon realm, human realm, something program. Exchange program, okay. Seeing Viney and, Emma. I can't believe I was blanking on her name. And that's not the healing coven, is it? No. And also, one of the Grudgeby ones, I always get it mixed up if that's Bo or Cat. I think that one's Bo. Yes, it is. Working with Alador, Darius, and that to create a way to unseal people's magic. And they had to use the only person who we actually saw get sealed on screen, that being the kid from Covention. Got to see Hunter is carving palismans for everyone, working with Dell. Which, yeah, that makes sense. Willow seems to be a professional Grudgeby player. Seems to have kept up her workouts by the looks of it. Oh, that's Warden Wrath and his son, who was getting the talisman from Hunter. I wasn't expecting to see them. I mean, it makes sense. The kid was in a witch school, so it makes sense for them to get a talisman eventually, but yeah, that was really nice. I was not expecting, let's be honest, I was expecting Balos to try and take over the Titan and everything. I was not expecting a kaiju dragon Balos to be firing corruption beams from above the castle. I was not expecting a Titan fused loose, but yeah, that was a wild episode, and we still did not see Matt and Steve interact with each other. Come on, when people pointed out that they looked similar and asked if they were siblings, Dana said, yeah, we wanted to explore that in the third season, but because of time restraints and everything, we couldn't get it done. And then they did not interact once in this finale. But yeah. You know, I said that I came into this episode blind, like completely blind. And, well, yeah, that is even more true than I thought. I saw what looked to be an animation before I quickly scroll past of Evelyn and Caleb, like, doing something. Like I said, I scrolled quickly past, so I didn't actually see what it was fully. And I thought that was from this episode, so I was expecting there to be something related with Luce and Belos to see Evelyn and Caleb actually being happy before Belos interfered. But no, that apparently was completely fair made and everything. Yeah, that was really enjoyable. I'm so glad that it finally became available to me, even if I did have to switch sites halfway through to actually get the ending of it. But yeah. Anyway, I don't really have much to say with that I didn't say throughout the episode. One thing I do have to say: what the hell was up with that little hootie worm in King's Dead's eye? Like, it's the same eye that we can still see in the collector's skull. But is that where Hootie comes from? Is he like some titan parasite thing? Because we never did get an explanation as to what he is. And yeah, so look, we all knew that the collector was going to be redeemed. Like, it's just a misguided child who doesn't understand what being mortal means and was really scorned for the actions of its family, not its own. As it said, it came down to this world. It was playing with the kids of the Titans, the ones that were its age, well, their age. I really shouldn't say it, but yeah, it was playing with people their age. Neither magic really worked on each other, so they couldn't really hurt each other any more than just normal kids could. And then the archivists had to come through and ruin everything. But yeah. Anyway, that was really enjoyable. For what they were able to do, I am really happy with how season 3 turned out. And yeah, so would have liked a full season 3, but that's just beating a dead horse at this point. But yeah, with that being said, I'll catch you guys in the next one.